you know that our community, it always is, feels good to feel like you belong. Imperfect disciple. Strength and grace when you can't interact together.
That's all the time.
Seriously.
Jared Wilson, we looked at this quote last week. I tend to think that a lot of the ways in the evangelical church teaches discipleship seem designed for people who don't appear to really need it. How about discipleship for the cut-ups and the screw-ups, the tired and the torn up and the weary and the lonely? What's it mean to grow? Jesus told his disciples, his followers, go and make disciples. Teach them to obey everything I've commanded you. And because people took that, traded in their life for Christ life, that's the reason that you and I know. It's not because any of the original disciples came to us, obviously. There were people through time that passed this on, lived their life. Are you tired, worn out, burned out of religion? Jesus says, come to me. Get away with me and you'll recover your life and I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I like that. When we follow God, it's not a forced thing. There's a rhythm to follow. It's a grace rhythm. You have to do this, or you better do this, or you must do this. We get to follow it. We get to be part of it. The song of life. Jesus says, I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting. Is all about effort. Rowing is all about you putting your stick into the water and making it go. That is not the Christian life. The first song talked about, Lord, be the wind inside my sails. Now, a sailboat, the only way that it moves through the wind. But yet there are 60 different procedures in a sailboat to get that thing running well. So it takes some effort to get the sails up and to maintain them well. It takes some effort for us to get into the place where the Spirit can blow us. It's not like, well, here I am. Blow on me, God. Here I am, Lord. Just blow your wind all over me and I'll do whatever you want me to do. Well, what are the sails that we have to put up? What are the places that God blows on us where He can take us down the river of life? One of these that we looked at last week was one of the parts of the sail is vulnerability. C.S. Lewis said, love and all is to be vulnerable. I think what we understand is that we can't follow God unless we love Him. Have you tried to follow someone you don't really like and love? How's that work? It's a fight all the time. I really don't want to do what you want to do. I really don't want to hear what you have to say. I'm really not going the direction you're going. But in order to love, it takes a vulnerability. But some of us, I think we put up with people that are not necessarily open about who we really are and what we really have. And I think we do the same with God. What the C.S. Lewis has to say, not anything in your heart will be wrung and possibly broken. That's somewhat the definition of vulnerability. When we are vulnerable, we open ourselves up to pain, the possibility of pain. But he goes on. You want to make sure of keeping your heart intact. You must give it to no one, not even an animal. You want to keep your heart intact. Don't give it away. Wrap it carefully around with hobbies and little luxuries. Avoid all entanglements. Lock it up safe in the casket or coffin of your selfishness. But in that casket, I like those words, casket. What do you put in caskets? Eventually, we die. Because we've not only blocked out maybe possible pain, we blocked out all the good. We blocked out growth. And in that casket, safe, dark, motionless, airless. It will change. Our heart will change. It will not be broken. Our heart will become unbreakable, impenetrable, irredeemable. To love is to be vulnerable. Just think about it. To love is to be vulnerable. How can we love if we're not vulnerable? Then the real us is an out. We're only performing when the real us is back. Do we have this relationship with God? One of the first requirements of love is vulnerability. That's when God becomes real. That's when we've laid our heart on the line. We've talked about it. That was last week. It's important, as the one song said, remind ourselves. Mm-hmm. We need to remind ourselves. As Norman Vincent Peale said, a good minister will continually remind the people what they already know. First time ever.